Hey, it's Professor Dave. Let's learn about geometry.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
If you could go back and visit any time in the history of mankind, which would it be? The Roaring Twenties? The Renaissance? Those are some pretty good ones, no doubt, but my pick would definitely be ancient Greece. This civilization produced some of the most astounding leaps of intellect in the history of our species. In this era, early society truly evolved into a form that held the triumphs of the mind in highest regard. And as a result, the Greeks revolutionized philosophy, government, and you guessed it, mathematics. While there were many important figures in these fields, some of the best work in math was done by a fellow named Pythagoras. His work influenced great thinkers like Plato, and therefore all of Western civilization. This early branch of mathematics, now called geometry, was derived largely from drawing pictures in the sand, and it is one of the oldest topics in math. Great thinkers would draw shapes like circles, rectangles, and triangles, and try to understand the characteristics of these perfect forms. In this way, mathematics came to be defined as the field of inquiry in which all questions have completely objective answers. The sum of two angles, the ratio of side lengths on a triangle, these are values that can be firmly arrived at and are completely inarguable, just like the solutions of polynomials that we studied in basic algebra. This kind of certainty was impossible in the crude physical world, the mysterious subject of natural philosophy. Mathematics was revered as the study of divine perfection in physical form, and Pythagoras even had a little bit of a club surrounding his beliefs about numbers. Or we can go ahead and say it, it was a cult, but a nice math cult. Its members were called Pythagoreans, and among their doctrines was a healthy dash of mysticism for good measure. Some of it turned out to be nonsense, of course, like their belief that the orbits of celestial bodies must obey perfect numerical ratios, just like the consonant musical intervals. As it turned out, this space symphony, as romantic as it sounds, is not real. The planets are distributed about the solar system more or less at random, just like every other planetary system we can see in our galaxy. But their contributions to math have stuck around, and between the work of Pythagoras and other great mathematicians like Euclid, mankind's ability to describe the universe was dramatically transformed. This change was so profound, in fact, that the geometry we learn in high school today is not very different from the geometry of this ancient time. So let's move forward and learn all about the shapes and angles and axioms that comprise the topic of geometry. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.